What's going on? Just hanging out.
Hello. There's an old Doritos bag. Oh no, it's does anyone want Doritos?
Right here.
Oh.
Toss it.
Toss it.
Okay.
Right there. Doritos.
Oh, I suck.
So. This is a reverse panel, which is really exciting. So, what we're gonna do is we'll throw out a question, and then you raise your hand if you have the answer. And then it's basically a reverse Q&A, so it's really exciting. So I hope you're ready to talk about things, share some stuff, know each other, feel what it's like to be questioned. Actions.
I would love that.
That'd be cool. I don't know if this will reach there. It might.
It will try.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Meanwhile, whoever does this is going to have to stroll on up here.
Take a stroll, grab the mic. It's your opportunity.
Okay, so I'll go ahead and start, and then you just raise your hand if you have any questions.
Should we?
Oh, yeah, do it.
I don't know, like, okay, this is, I'm Jade Saxton, I'm a voice actor and ADR director, I'm happy to join.
Hi, I'm Mia Clark, I am a voice actor, I have directed and written scripts for Annie May, primarily, I do a lot of work for Funimation, but I've also done work for other stuff, too. We do a little bit of games, a little bit of commercial. Anything you do with your voice, you do it, right?
Yeah. Pretty much.
So we do these cons, and we have like a lot of Q&As, so I thought it might be kind of fun to give you guys one. Because there's a lot of things that I want to know that I don't know. So,
ooh, yes.
We have, yeah, see, they're just like, these are just things that I'm curious about, and I'm,
yeah.
So.
I hope we asked you for 29, that's not
So, first thing I want to know is, like, does the guest lineup affect, like, whether or not you go to a convention? So, are you, like, would you go to, I don't know, con because so-and-so is in it, and only because they're in it, or would you go anyway because you just want to go? So, raise your hand, and if you have an answer, come tell us. We're curious.
For that kind of question, I do have one. Yeah. I have an answer for that. Yeah, let me zoom out so I can actually get in here.
Awesome. Thanks. This mic right here is available.
Now, your question was, would I go to a convention with certain guests was there?
Like, well, does it matter? Like, if you, like, let's say that you're just, like, looking for conventions, does it matter who's going? Like, do the guests change your mind or increase your chances of going?
Well, for me, one particular guest, because that person was ever announced, I'd go on a heartbeat. It fits kind of in my driving distance.
Yeah.
But I also like to talk about, see about the con itself, good reviews, bad reviews. Mm. Some conventions I have heard really negative reviews, so that really does deteriorate from it. And maybe, if let's say the guest is rare to meet, that could actually be a bad review. Let's put it into it.
Cool.
May I ask a follow-up?
Yeah, please.
Excellent. Yes, I have a follow-up question for you. For you, a follow-up. Where do you read reviews for conventions?
I have friends, I look up online, and I thought I'd read something about animecons.com, and also when I come here with conventions, usually 18-plus stories from you guests also. I take that back into account.
Oh,
we have so much responsibility for that.
Oh. Yeah, because I have heard some horror convention stories. One in particular from Tiffany Grant, actually, which I'm not going to discuss which convention that is.
Oh, wow.
Right on. All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Jade, your turn.
Do I get to pick a cue?
Yeah.
Ooh, a cue from baby.
These are all things I want to know.
Oh, I like number 20.
Okay.
Number 20. You don't know what it is. Raise your hand if you want to answer it. I'm not going to tell you what the question is. Right on. Grab the mic.
Grab the mic, step on up.
Step on up, the microphone, the make it be microphone. I'm a rapper, y'all. I really did just rap in an anime. It was pretty fun. Is that on?
I don't think so.
Oh, switch it on. There you go.
Yeah, we got some microphone action. All right. My question to you is, and what was your name ringing?
Colin.
Colin. Colin, what are your talents?
Yeah, see, there it is.
There it is, that moment.
I can improv.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
I love it. I am terrified of improv.
Same.
But you don't do it.
That's so cool, yeah. Like you go to like play improv games, stuff like that.
Yeah, again, I took two classes in it, so just over the past year or so.
I've been thinking about doing that because they say that it kind of, it takes the edge off of your fear in any audition if you do improv, because you've already like humiliated yourself in every way possible in front of everyone.
Well, I know how you do that too.
That's another hidden talent of yours. Awesome, thank you so much. Right on, Colin. Yeah, yeah.
Woo. All right. Woo-hoo-hoo. I want to know, who wants to answer a question first? About con stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm here.
All right.
And I just want to know, what's your best experience, like your best convention experience? One that you could be like, oh man, that one.
Guest.
The corn.
Corn himself.
Yeah.
I don't know. It was this panel, and my hair was pink then.
Mhm.
And we had the voice actors all up here asking each other questions, and then the guests would ask questions too. And I don't know. One of the guests asked if somebody any color they want their hair to be, and I can't think of who our one guest was, but she said pink, and then she like pointed at me, and she's like. Like her hair color. And she likes that natural. It's totally natural.
Wouldn't it be cool if we could, yeah, just grow our hair in like all the shades of the rainbow? That would
cool.
be amazing. Yeah.
Yep. All right.
Thanks so much.
Note to self. Talk about hair colors.
Awesome.
All right.
Is it my turn?
Yeah.
Wish I had a dye to roll. Yeah. Roll that dye.
When
yes. Yes. Until I have it for the next question, I am going to ask this one. Okay. Who would like to answer a question? I'll throw it out there, and then anyone can raise their hand. This question says, "What is it about a voice actor that makes you become a fan? Is it more of their work or their personality?" Does anyone have an answer? Thank you so much. Oh, it's so cute. It's a tiny little
thing. You have that one. I got 30 more.
What? Thank you. Oh, I almost lost it already. God bless America. All right. Who wants to answer this cue?
This cue. Do you have an A?
I'm going to start calling on people.
I know. I'm calling on
you.
Oh.
I choose call you. You, sir. That is right. We're on the spot all the time. It's your turn. All right, so I'll ask it again. What is it about a voice actor that makes you become a fan? Is it more their work, like their body of work, or their personality when you meet them like at a convention?
Yeah.
For me, it's probably like their work. And then also, like, you see them in your show that you watch, and then you just like that character. And then
Yeah, same, I think.
Yeah.
For sure, like, when I think about that, you don't really know the person, but if you like the person too.
What if, like, you really like their work and you meet them and they're just like, then all of a sudden do you not like them or do you still watch their stuff?
Yeah, I still watch their stuff.
Yeah! Alright, cool.
Thank you.
Alright. Oh, there's a die? Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do this and, like, count. All right. How do you decide what character you want to cosplay? Come here. Talk to me about this.
Okay.
Woohoo! Yay!
Well, I mostly decide based on if I feel like I kind of am the character.
Oh, yeah.
So
like personal.
Relatability.
Yeah, personal. Like, for this getup, I'm Chat Noir, a character who is fun-loving but feels like he's kind of reserved by his family and kind of his role in society.
Yeah.
And I can feel that because I am way too weird for the world.
So that's how you decided that. It's like you feel like you relate to the character and then you...
Yes.
So it's not like how it would, like, they look like or necessarily their design. It's more just like what you feel.
Yeah.
That's cool.
If I feel weird, like, oh, I don't want to dress like that. Or, you know, like, oh, I can't wear something like that. Like a bodysuit or something. I was like, oh, I'm going to get a dress.
Cool.
So it doesn't really matter about that. Like,
I'm not blonde.
Heck no. But that's
pretty cool. I totally thought that was your hair.
Thank you.
Cool.
Awesome. Thank you.
All right, Jade.
Okay, I'm gonna roll twice.
Ask something cool.
I'm roll twice. And add it.
Six and
seven.
Seven.
All right. Oh. Okay. Okay, I got one. How often do you watch anime? Who wants to answer? Yeah, come on down. You're the next contestant.
Mountain Dew, Mountain Dew, Mountain Dew.
Do the Dew.
For me personally, I've always been a big fan of anime, so I tend to keep a track of whatever's newly released. So I'm always watching some, because I tend to watch it about, well, binge watch it 3-4 times a week, depending on what's released. Especially from Funimation.
Do you watch like one episode and call it, or do you just like watch like the full anime, or do you watch live episodes, or how?
If it's currently being released,
yeah,
like Hero Academia or anything like that, I will watch the new episode and I'll keep up to date as it goes.
Okay.
And then I'll watch everything else with it, or I'll pick a series and I'll just watch the entire thing and let it go.
Cool.
Done.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah.
Getting so much knowledge.
Great knowledge. All of it.
All right. I want to know what your least favorite types of panels are at cons.
Oh no. Oh no.
All right.
Who
wants to do it?
29. You asked it.
I did. I got it out of the way. I just wanted to just get it out of the way. So let's just accept it, Jade.
I'm going to breathe through it.
Just breathe through it. It's okay. We'll get it over with and we'll ask something fun. Come here.
I'm scared now.
This is the whole point of this panel. It's my learning experience, so go for it.
Sorry, but the Homestuck panels, there's always like the crowds for the Homestuck panels, and I mean, Homestuck people are alright, I have no problems with them, but they just kind of like crowd the hallways, and they're just,
Homestuck?
They're gray
with the horns.
I think it's going on right now, actually.
They're gray with the horns.
The troll skin,
like,
the horns.
I've seen those. Yeah. I never knew what those were. What do they do? Like, what is it? Is it like
it's a web, yeah. Web internet comic? Yeah. Or it's like a, but it's like a create your path kind of thing? Yeah.
There's just always way too many cosplayers, and they always like take too long.
And I always feel bad. I always feel bad for the hotel staff for when they shower with all that gray makeup.
Oh gosh, because they're like in gray.
I've heard they stain the walls. I've heard that's one of the con horror stories I've heard is the Homestucks like.
Homestucks.
Like they mess up all the sheets and they mess up all, from all that makeup. It's very cool. Yeah.
Oh my god, I was waiting for you to say it. All your panels do it.
I know. I was so scared.
Alright, Jade, go.
Oh, it's my turn!
Big money, get it.
Standing on, it's exciting, it's getting real over here. If any other voice actor portrayed your favorite anime character other than who's playing it now, would you be their fan instead?
So, like, let's say you're a huge Big Mini specifically how Vic Mignogna played that role that makes you that fan of theirs. Come to us. We want to know this.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
You have a stand now.
One of my favorite characters that I've from one of my favorite anime actually had this happen recently with the new Escaflowne dub. And the short answer to your question is basically no. I really just like the way that the original actor portrayed the character, and that's really what just makes me like the character.
So if somebody else played it, you wouldn't like the character?
Potentially not. It depends on how the new person would portray the character.
Okay.
It just depends.
Cool.
Yeah, that's hard. I feel you on that one. And this will happen the more you get older, too. They remake movies a lot. And like when they remade Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, I was like, nah.
Nah. James, like, table over.
Nah.
Nope.
And I love Johnny Depp, but I was like, nah. Like,
Yeah.
It's just weird sometimes. So I feel you on that.
That's cool.
But yeah. Thank you.
Thanks. Okay, I want to know, what do you do with the stuff we autograph? Like, if you give us like a shirt, do you wear the shirt? Or I've signed like people's stuffed animals. Do you sleep with the stuffed animals still, or do you like put it on the shelf? Like, what do you do with the stuff?
I collect all autographs, so I pick up. I might answer this one.
Yeah,
nice.
Well, to answer that about the shirt, I actually have two different Funimation shirts. I just keep them around. I guess I want to collect more signatures. Eventually, I'd like to get enough and maybe just hang them on a wall or something and frame them. But for anything else, it just stays in my collection. If it's a poster, I have to frame it.
Okay, cool.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it's a shirt, it goes on the wall, if it's a poster. Now, what about like the DSs and guitars and stuff? I've only signed two.
Oh, yeah. I've signed swords.
Swords?
Yeah.
I've signed so many swords. Do you still use the sword? Is that going on the wall now?
If I had put my mind on a sword collector, it'd probably still be hung on to the shirt.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because my nephew at one point used to collect swords, and I actually saw them hung up.
Cool.
And I'm pretty sure he doesn't have that collection anymore now.
Yeah. Awesome, thank you.
Yeah. I'm gonna go to pitch too, just for fun.
Do it, yeah. Look at that. Ask me the things. These are things that I'm like, yes, excited about.
Oh, I'm gonna know this. And, we'll see. I don't know if this is applicable, but how many people are staying in your hotel room?
Raise your hand if you're staying in a hotel room.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, no need to come to the mic, just call it out.
Just two.
Two, okay.
Four. How many people?
Yeah.
I have my own room.
Oh, nice.
Four?
Okay. I wonder if at like a really big con, if it gets crazy.
Well, so, yeah, because like, I was talking to somebody, and it was real quick through the autograph line, and she was like talking about how so-and-so is in her room tonight, but maybe they're in someone else's room, and I think I have like so-and-so and so-and-so in my room. And like before she could leave, I was like, how many people in your room, girl?
How many people?
How many all squeeze in those little baby rooms?
And I've heard, because I've made some friends with some of the artists from Artist Alley also go to a lot of conventions.
Oh, yeah.
And so I've talked to some of them about like how they manage. And a lot of them make friends with each other and then therefore share.
And they just share rooms.
Yeah. And they'll do like two to four people of artists.
Okay.
And they do that like to kind of lower their overhead or whatever you want to call it for
stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, here's the thing. Like furry outfits, like the furries.
I'm sorry. It's nothing about what you're saying.
and I'm kind of like, you know, they've got the big wolf head, and they're just like head to toe in like animal garb. A, what is that? And B, like, are you hot in there? Is it hot in there? Does anyone have an answer to this? Are y'all
excited about it.
And then,
her fans.
They want her sort of definition of the furry. There's people who appreciate anthropomorphic animals, and then there are people who are attracted to anthropomorphic animals.
Attracted to them?
Yes.
Are we all
talking
about
it's a thing.
Are you serious?
I don't understand.
Yeah.
How do you not do this?
I thought this was like a wolf show or something.
No.
Like,
you were so full of it. No, you did not. You did not. They have entire furry conventions.
Yeah, but what is that about? Like,
well, part of it's like, go be a furry, enjoy yourself, and part of it's, let's go back to the room later and fur it up. I watched like a documentary about it. That's the only thing I know.
Wait, in the furry outfit.
I don't know how it works. Like, I didn't watch them do that. But
I didn't. Okay, see, I just didn't know if it was like a game. Like, I thought like, okay, it's either one. It's either that.
Some people identify as that. It's like an identity.
Like they're just.
Like you are a female, they identify as furry.
As a wolf. Okay.
Yes. It's a thing.
Check M or F or
I'll send you the documentary. I have a list.
No,
going.
I want to
I have
see
a list
this.
Going for you, because remember I have that yeah.
Yes.
That other list. Is it my turn? Oh gosh.
I'm gonna go back to page one. I feel like page two is getting a little rough. Alright.
Sorry guys.
Oh, 34, yeah, okay. What types of posts on your social media do you like to read? Do you like more personal quips, or do you look mostly for first notifications of projects and appearances?
Like, if you follow us on Twitter, like, what do you, or Insta, or anything, do you like it when we just post, I had strawberries this morning, or is it more like, hey, here's the new role that I have, or something?
Yeah.
What is most interesting to you?
Yeah, there's a mic. Come on up.
I'll just talk loud.
Okay.
I like when voice actors post about fan experiences or meeting certain people or things like that.
Okay.
Fan experiences. Yeah. I like to take like photos with cosplayers and stuff like that. I always find that really cool.
That's cool.
I made Leah take one with a group of
dragons.
Dragons last week. Dragon maids made dragon cosplay. Yeah. But she was just not having it, but I made her.
I just got scared.
I was like, get over here, Leah.
I get it today. They all look so cute, and I'm like,
no.
Like, hi, dragon. You're seeing these dragons.
Cool. It was great.
Okay. Wait. I think this is more kind of the same thing. Oh God, yes, 35. Do you go to YouTube and watch panels from other cons or something? Like, I see people shooting panels sometimes, and like this guy.
Yeah.
Hi. But are you gonna get as much effect out of that as a video as you would a live experience? He says no.
Yes. There's certain guests that I can't go see, so I'll watch them later.
Okay.
But does it bore you?
I'll see them if they're in the area first, but
yeah.
I don't think it's boring. Well, it depends how many questions there are. How do I become a voice actor? But
it's always there. I'm gonna start like bringing like little dots, like those get dot candies, and the first person to ask me that, I'm just gonna be like, oh, I know you've seen that in a video or somewhere. No, I'm just kidding. It's totally fine. You can ask that question.
You're going to throw dots at people?
Throw dots at people.
Those are hardcore candies. Those would be painful.
Dots? No.
I once got a dot, like, I had to go to
you
a
got
dinner.
Dotted?
I got, no, listen, I'm just saying, like, they're so hardcore that, like, it required a trip to the dentist because it was, like, all up in my braces. Don't eat dots when you have braces. Don't do it. It's a bad idea.
They're so good.
They're so not good for your teeth. They're, yeah, I guess they really should just be used to be thrown at people randomly.
Yeah, we used to throw dots in movie theaters back in the days. Okay.
Back in the days, oh, throw in the dots. Woo-woo!
Okay, Is that a thing? Anyway, raise your hand. Okay. Do you want to be a voice actor or do you want to be an anime character? Curious.
What's wrong with both?
Well, because one is real and the other is not.
In truth, I want to be a voice actor because I kind of want to be a part of those worlds. I want to do I do stage work and I still feel like I'm a part of that stage world I'm in. Mm. I put myself in there as a character. So I just want to be a little bit of myself in these fun, fantastic worlds that are so imaginative and creative all the time.
Okay. Who else said that has a hand? I want to know. Y'all.
It was pretty much the same as him. I always look at characters, and whenever a voice actor portrays them, they bring such life to them. Because I've watched some stuff, and I've watched some dub. I prefer dub, mainly because it's slower.
Same.
And you can't play Candy Crush while you're watching sub.
That's true.
But it always brings a new depth to the character for me. When anyone, those big inspirational moments that they do, the long monologues, that brings the character to a realization. And that's kind of why I want to see that. Those inspirational moments that bring to someone else.
But you can do that with stage acting too, film acting.
Yes.
So would you want to do that too, film and stage?
I would have.
Okay.
I just don't, I'm not very good at it.
That's not true.
But this way, I don't have the money for classes.
Gotcha. Okay, cool. Just curious. Go.
Oh,
Okay, 16. Is anime, a common interest in your school if you are in a school of sorts? Yeah.
I go to Notre Dame Academy, which is up a ways a bit, but it's still in Toledo. We have an anime club, which is basically just a bunch of weirdos sitting in a dark room. Yeah, it's small. And they actually had to open it up to the lower classmen because
they got that open.
What?
I know my little sister went to Notre Dame and they were trying to put one together, I think.
Yeah, it took a while. Because
I've heard a lot of places that have a club at their school or have been contacted to do Skype interviews and stuff for anime clears. So do y'all follow up question? Do y'all just get together once a week and watch anime? What do you do in an anime club? Tell me.
So our schedule's weird. We have blue and gold days. We have 4 classes a day, but they're a blocked schedule. So one day you'll have the first 4 and they'll be 75 minute long classes, and the other day you'll have the other 4. Yeah, it's fun.
That sounds rough.
But we have ours every other Tuesday.
Uh-huh.
That was a gold day. So we had 3 meetings. It was a lot more than that, but we would watch anime together, or we would have holiday parties, and there would be pictures.
I love a good theme.
Yeah, they're for Christmas, one girl dressed up as Santa with big anime eyes.
Anime Santa? Yes.
It was fun, but it brought us closer together because there were so few of us. So we were just it was nice and. We never actually ended up watching anything, just sort of commenting on, because we had already seen it.
Like a hangout until we all could chat about it.
Yeah, we got to talk about what we felt when we watched it.
So it's almost like a book club, for
yeah.
Anime.
Yeah.
I did it. Yeah.
Yeah.
How many people are in your club?
There's, depending on the week, anywhere from 4 to
12. Oh, nice. Right on. All right. It's your turn, Miss Clark.
I want to know.
I want to know.
If you could be an additional cast member in any anime, which one would it be? And it's a character that doesn't even exist. So you would just create your own character, all of a sudden there's a side storyline. Which one would be, and who would you be in that? All right.
my favorite anime is Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. So it's like, I don't know, it's like the ultimate anime manga for me.
Yeah.
I just love all the characters. So I want to be in it after they try to destroy the world. Because I don't want to be part of dying. Well, let's be in like the peaceful Amestris.
Yeah.
I don't know, I just...
What would your character be like? Would
you I think it'd be kind of fun to be an automail engineer, like Winry.
Oh, cool.
Or an alchemist. No, I think it'd be fun to be automail engineer.
Okay. Cool. Good to know.
Okay, I'm going in front of a one. Just going for
just
it.
Go ahead.
I'm going for it. I get asked this a lot, so now it's your turn to answer. What's your favorite anime and why?
Do it.
Mm-hmm. It's hard, isn't it? That's right.
No, it's kind of easy.
Okay. You haven't answered one yet.
Oh.
The green shirt.
Should I stand up or am I going to get...
You can, there's a microphone.
Project your voice, you want to sit there.
I have a pretty loud voice.
Sweet. All right.
My favorite anime is Code Geass, because I like how deep and twisty it is.
Dark and twisty anime.
You just keep you on your toes.
Mm-hmm. We could do a few more on that one, the other two that raise their hand. Yeah?
Yeah.
Who else raise their hand? Yes.
I'm so torn between either Orin High School Host Club or Ghost Hunt, because both of those I watch with my family, and like Orin High School, my sister and I really like, so that like that's sort of like our bonding time, because we're, you know, she's sporty and athletic and does all sorts of like social things. I'm artsy and I just kind of sit at home, but that's the one show that we both really like together, and I just like the storyline. Like, Ghost Hunt was, I watched with my dad, and that was sort of like, I hate being scared, but I like scary things, and so, like, it was just kind of nice because, you know, my dad's, like...
You like a suspenseful situation, but you don't want to jump scare. I feel you on that. I'm the same, yeah.
Or, I like the adrenaline rush, but I don't like actual scary things.
Yeah. Like, you don't actually want to be chased by someone with a chainsaw.
Yeah. Like, Ghost Hunt had some, like, mm-hmm. It actually brought, like, Ghost Hunt specifically brought in some really cool, like, their plot lines actually had real life situations with, I like researching actual, like, scary things that have happened. It's a weird, like, don't scare me. But
no,
I'm really
like,
scared.
Well, one, that was my first big anime role, was in Ghost Hunt as Moscovara, and two, this girl right here, as far as like real life searching out those things, like she's all about that. She loves actual ghost hunting.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
for
she loves that.
It's my fave.
She's made me go to some hotel and like try and commune with the dead or something. I don't know.
It was fun. You didn't stay. Did you stay?
I fell asleep.
Yeah, Jay fell asleep before it was ghost time. It was time to hunt ghosts.
I'm such a grandma. But you were showing me videos and you were like, I saw a flicker of light.
I saw it.
It was like an orb. It was a ghost, a ghosty Magoo.
Jay's making fun of my ghost hunting.
I love it. I love your ghost hunting.
Can we go ghost
Didn't you say that one? Never mind.
That one person had like gear?
Did
yeah, Rachel Messer has gear. And she hasn't been to my house yet. Like she, Rachel, does anyone know my Rachel Messer? She's another voice actress. She lives in Tulsa and she was renting a room in my house for like 3 weeks. So I was really excited. She just like rented it and then like never showed up. I don't know. Apparently she's gonna be there next week.
Use your.
I'm gonna tell her, bring your gear, because she's at Tokyo and Tulsa right now. But tell her.
Bring
come
your
back.
Gear.
Bring
your
gear.
Gear.
Bring it. Okay. Are we on to the next?
I think so, yeah.
I wanna know what you like most about going to conventions, just in general. Like what makes you like wanna do this?
Meeting people like you.
Aww. So you come for the guests?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. That's cool. That's awesome. Yeah.
Being able to hide behind a cosplay mask, be something, see something and something you normally want to do. Gets rid of the inhibitions.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Yeah.
Being able to dress like this because in public, no one knows what you're doing.
They're just like, who's that cat girl? Like, what's happening? But here it makes sense, yeah.
Making new friends.
Aww. Making friends. I love that. Getting to meet people who have the same interests as you. Because, like, at our school, we have a lot of people that are into all the things I'm into.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I had another question in here that's kind of like a follow up to that, which is, so, like, when you're at a con, do you just, like, assume a friendship with everybody because you know that you all have the same thing in common, or is it still like you don't know each other so you're still like strangers, or is it safe space? Like, how does that work? Yes.
I'm pretty shy, but like in a place like this or like in something relevant to a con, like I'm friendly because once again, like, we're all having a similar interest to a similar topic.
Yeah.
So it's like, I mean, nobody is really going to be like, here, it's, I hate anime. Like, it's not, unless you're like the mom that brought their 15-year-old son. So
it's just like hating life right now. Cool. Yeah.
For me, like, Canadian people here, like, this is my first big con, and I just kind of noticed, like, everyone's really open. Like, because on the street, you're kind of like, I'm not going to talk to you. Person walking behind me, you know, like, sit next to you in a panel, I'm going to start talking to you. I probably won't ever see you again, but we're going to talk in depth about many subjects.
That's cool.
I love that. A little bit too. Just like acceptance, love.
Just like a, yeah, that makes sense. Mm-hmm. So it's like, you can't just come for us, right? There's so many, like, we're only on for like 3 hours.
Yeah, and so I guess this
and the con is like all weekend.
This is sort of another follow-up to the same subject.
Oh,
so I'm going to dive right in. I'm going to do it.
Do it.
What do you do when you're not at our panels?
Yeah, what else do you do?
What do y'all do?
At the con?
Yeah, like, yeah. What happens? What is the secret life of anime fans? Go here, yeah.
I take pictures of the cosplays and stuff.
Oh, you're a budding photographer.
Yes.
I do that as well. Yeah, I'm a shopper.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I also feel like the arts vendors, they're just sitting there, like, waiting for something.
Yeah.
Like, if you, like, see something that, like, you love them, but let's talk about that. That's
cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. Anything else? What else
can
we do?
Yeah.
I'm in the autograph lines. I know, it's, Chubbs is always getting me on about it, like, he said it's so good.
Really?
Yeah.
Cool. Cool. Yeah. See, I learned something.
Yeah.
Good morning. Do you have something, Jay?
What? It's my turn. Oh. What is your worst experience at a con?
No one wants to say. Yeah.
So, I won't say which con, but I went to a con where they were having a DJ. And I thought, okay, the guy was named DJ Soli. Okay, so you're from the anime type thing. I'll check it out. Come back in a DJ B. Well, I go to the panel, the room where it's supposed to be, and I walk in, and there's this one big dude in the front dancing to music on his phone. He was the DJ. There was no gear. All of his DJs was on his phone.
Oh no.
But he didn't even have a speaker?
He didn't have a speaker. He just plugged it into his phone and just put it to the side and was like dancing on there, just playing whatever he had, and it wasn't even good. I'm like,
it's like his.
You're like, well, I'm DJ.
It was one of those where it's like, this is the DJ?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, that's
That's not fun, y'all. Mm-hmm. Bam.
You're up, Leah.
What panels or stuff that would you like to see done or done by voice actors and stuff?
Oh, but it's not done by voice actors?
That is done by voice actors.
Oh, like an Ask an Anime Character panel.
Ask an Anime Character?
I've done one. It takes, depending on the meeting, just so you know, like, sometimes takes a lot of setup by someone smarter than me.
Oh.
Like, I did one once where we were all behind a screen and we had a keyboard and it had, we turned in beforehand like three or four characters that we voiced, and we, on the keyboard it had like little miniature photos of different emotional moments of those characters, like Carla being mad or Carla being sassy or whatever. And like, so someone on the audience would ask a question and then you would press that and it would pop up on a screen out there and you would answer it in the character.
Oh.
So it takes a lot of prep.
You can do it without pictures.
Yeah. And you definitely could, but that was like, it was intense. It's also a lot of pressure because I feel like they want you to like say really funny stuff, and I'm like, what?
Like, all I have is me.
Yeah. And then it kind of goes off the rails, which that does get kind of fun. What else?
I want to know, or you asked that.
More
security.
More show specific with multiple voice actors in the panel.
Do you like the show specific ones?
Well, not necessarily show specific, but it's more fun when the multiple actors are able to interact with each other.
We agree. We've been preaching
prayer. The panel almost always put solo panels, which is, solo panels are okay too, but it's nice to have group ones as well.
Yeah, I think it's, for us too, I think it's more interesting, because then we get other people's perspective and stuff like that. So, like, how did you get into anime? Like, is it one of those things where your friend told you, or you discovered on your own? Yeah.
I just think my story is kind of, it's one of the strangest ones I've heard. I don't know about everyone else, but my babysitter, when I was like 6, she watched anime when she was babysitting us, and that's how my siblings and I all got into anime. We started out with Rurouni Kenshin and Yu Yu Hakusho. Like, we didn't watch Sailor Moon and DBZ, no offense to those ones, but we started out with real hardcore stuff when I was, like, really young.
You were too young to watch the hardcore stuff. Oh, babysitters.
Yes. My uncle was really, really weird, and he, not, like, weird in a bad way, but he was, like, anime and gaming and art and like all sorts of like odd hobbies. And he passed away very young. And I sort of like, I wanted to, because I was young too, and I wanted to be able to connect with him more. It was a weird situation. But like, wanted to know why he liked stuff like that. And so I kind of got into it. That's how I started drawing, and I started watching anime. And so that's sort of how, like, and that's another, like, weird way to get into it, but...
That's cool.
It's so interesting listening to you, because, like, all of your stuff, like, you must be really close to your family, because all of your memories and your favorite things are, like, related to different familial relationships.
That is really cool.
Oh,
you did it?
Yeah, my brother used to play Dragon Ball Z on PS2 in front of me, so that's how I got into it.
Amazing, yeah?
Anime was always sort of around me, like, growing up, but it wasn't until I was, like, in high school and I was going through some depression stuff that some animes came that really spoke, that really kind of got me out of that sort of dark area and place. And just help me express myself a bit more and move on.
Cool. Beautiful.
Thank you. I watched a bunch of cartoons as a kid, and I saw anime, and I thought it was another cartoon, so I just kept watching it, and that's how I got into anime.
Yeah. That's kind of like some of the things we watched when you were younger.
Yeah.
Labeled that way, but they were, actually.
Yeah. So that's interesting. So I always thought, I didn't know if it was something you just happened upon, like you did, or if it's something that's like word of mouth, you know?
Yeah.
Like my friend watched it. I see a lot of like families coming up to autograph sessions, so it'll be like a mom and her kid, and they're both like fans of it, and the kid is because the mom is and stuff.
Yeah.
It's cool. Mm-hmm. Cool. Yes.
Eventually, it's a big explosion, like, oh, I know! Or I have to go look it up, and I'm like, oh, yeah. I just, it bothers me when I know, and I'm like,
Yeah. Cool. Yes.
Actually, the Hitachi twins from Warren High School House Club, I really liked their voices, and I kept hearing them. And, like, I didn't realize that, like, voice acting was, you know, it's the same as acting. Multiple actors play multiple roles. And so, like, I kept noticing, and I was like, oh, it's Kaoru. And so I started looking up at, looking at the credits, and, you know, oh, it's the same guy. And specifically because of, like, the twins, I started looking at other voices that I liked. Like, that's how I found out about Leah and then Jade, too. So, like, that's why I got so excited, like, last year when Micah was here. And like, you know, it's Soul Eater. That was pretty cool.
Yeah. That is really cool.
I was just about to think of that.
Do you judge people based on like the quality of their cosplay? Are you like, oh, that person didn't spend as much time and effort in mine, I did, or yeah?
No, because I've been there myself.
I don't judge people on that either. I just, if I can automatically tell what the character is, I will go up and ask them for their picture. Especially if they're like more obscure characters.
Yeah.
Because I know I cosplayed this one character from Pandora Hearts. I don't know if anybody knows the anime. It's an older anime, so it had a fan base, but it like died. And I cosplayed this character called Xerxes Break. And I know it made me really happy when people asked for my picture. And it made fans really, really happy that they saw what people were cosplaying.
Oh, cool.
So it doesn't matter if it's good, just as long as it's recognizable.
So y'all don't have, like, a competition? Like, you don't feel, like, competitive with each other? You're just kind of like, oh, okay, we're all on the same thing. We're all into this, so it's all good. That's cool. I didn't know if it was, like, you know, certain, like, in video world, which is the world that I'm in, if you make videos and create them, you are always trying to be better than the other. that a video for something similar? No. And if it was a thing.
Do you have something you want to know about?
I want to know, okay, if you mess with the elevators in hotel rooms at cons, why do you do that? I really want to know. Does anyone do that? Like ride up and down and do that stuff? You do it? Why?
Sometimes to avoid someone on a floor, if your room's on the 7th floor and you see somebody there, like, I'm still going up, I'm meeting somebody. Just, you know, go up more.
Okay.
All the way to the top.
But you don't, like, ride the elevator for no reason?
Oh, for no reason, no.
Who are you? Are you in here? Do you ride the elevator for no reason? Anyway, come on. It's okay. I'm not going to get mad. I'm just curious. This is like, I just want to know. I just have to know. Why?
I actually did do it. I did one for no reason.
Okay, why?
I had to kill time.
You had to kill time! Okay. Good.
Riding the elevator like it was a...
I'm just going to be like, next time I'm late to a panel, I'll be like, someone trying to kill time, I guess, because I could not get my elevator straight. Okay.
Do you have one?
Do it.
Do you make ramen in the coffee maker?
Yeah, at hotels. Do you do it? Why?
No.
No one does the. No one makes ramen.
I didn't even know that was a thing until I read
they
this.
They do it sometimes. I've heard
it's
it.
It's a microwave. You can use it. It's more of a life hack than anything else.
You can just make ramen.
A hotel room hack.
Somebody said that to me once, and I just wanted to see who it was out there. So it's Gil. Yeah, he does it.
I haven't done it. I just know. Oh.
The oh. Okay. Cool.
I heard some college kids do that. Make yeah. Their like grilled cheese on the iron.
Nice. Okay, so I already asked a furry question. that too. Oh my gosh, this is great. What about the giant props that y'all carry for cosplay? Does anyone carry them? Do they get heavy? And at what point do you decide you're going to put it down? Or do you commit and you're just like, I'm going to carry this?
Being a theater actor, I'm committed to the part. So I will hold it no matter how much my arm hurts.
Are you sick? Oh my gosh.
Same with headdresses, you know.
You just have to go.
Pain is beauty.
No, true. I did a headdress gig once for a gala event where they airbrushed me to look like this underwater queen. And they put on some huge Vegas-style headdress. I thought I was going to die after 30 minutes, and I had to do it for 2 more hours.
Oh my gosh.
And I was like, never again. I can't commit to that again. Like, it was just so painful.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. I was in a remade version of Cinderella. It was the Broadway edition, not at Broadway, it was through school. But I had like 5 different roles because nobody auditioned. And one of them was a palace guard. And the costume was disgusting. I looked like an angry, like, salt shaker. Because the hat was like the top of a salt shaker. And then it was black and white with a silver sequin vest.
Oh my
and then
gosh.
These big, like, these giant, like, golden pitchforks of, like, torches. And they were so heavy. And, like, you would look at them like, oh, it's, like, really thin. It's probably hollow. No, they were like, it was like cement or something. And then, like, because we were guards, we weren't supposed to move at all. And I was at the top of a staircase, and these girls, they were, you know, Cinderella, these huge ball gowns, they would walk past me and, like, brush me aside. And I would, like, shift, and my pitchfork thing would, like, fall over, and I'd have to, like, catch it. It was, you know, angry salt shaker, I swear. It's exactly what it was.
That sounds rough.
Okay, last question. Do you follow us on Twitter and Instagram? Raise your hand if you do. Okay, for the rest of you, my handle for Twitter is Leah Clark, VA, as in voice actor. And same on Instagram. What's yours, Jade?
Oh, I'm at Jade B. Saxton, JadeBSaxton on Twitter, and then I'm on Insta, I'm at Jaderade, like Gatorade. Jaderade.
Yeah.
I'm on Facebook too, Jade Saxton, voice actor, Tris.
I am too. I'm not good at Facebook. I'm more active on Twitter and Insta than anything, so yeah. So if you want to increase the quality of your life, follow these Twitters and Instas. for engaging us.